Introducing Thermo Calc 2024b, released in June 2024. This release introduces printability maps in the Additive Manufacturing Module, significant speed improvements in the Property Model Calculator, several new features and products for titanium users, including a titanium model library, and a new titanium aluminide-based alloys database, and more. This release also includes 9 new databases, including our first ever databases for the refractory alloys, molybdenum, and niobium. The Additive Manufacturing Module, or AM Module, receives several updates in this release, the most significant being the addition of printability maps, also known as process maps. Printability maps allow users to plot the likelihood of 3 possible defects that occur during additive manufacturing: keyholing, lack of fusion, and balling. These 3 defects occur based on the speed and power used during the AM process, so printability maps allow you to reduce the risks of these defects by showing the speed and power settings that are optimal, allowing you to calibrate your system to avoid these issues. You can learn more about this new feature in the release notes or by joining our release webinar. A video will also be available in the summer of 2024 describing this new feature in detail. The Additive Manufacturing Module also adds 2 new calculation types for steady-state simulations: batch and grid. The new calculation types allow users to compare how a range of power and scan speeds affect the melt pool dimensions. The batch calculation type allows users to input power and scan speed data from a file, such as a spreadsheet. Users can include experimental melt pool dimensions, if they have them, and compare them to the calculated results using a new plot type called a parity plot. This calculation can also be visualized using another new plot type called melt pool versus energy density, which shows the melt pool dimensions as a function of energy density, or with the new printability maps we discussed earlier. The grid calculation type evaluates power and scan speed for a fixed range and number of steps. Results are visualized using the new printability map or the melt pool versus energy density plot type. Both new calculation types can also be visualized using 3D plots and plot over line, which were already available in the software. A drop-down menu has been added so that users can view these plots for each of the datasets. The keyhole model in the Additive Manufacturing Module has been expanded to include fluid flow, which provides a better prediction of the melt pool size. The keyhole model was originally introduced last December in Thermo Calc 2024a to improve on predicting the depth of the melt pool. Keyholing can occur with low scanning speed and high power. By adding fluid flow to the model, the program now offers more accurate predictions of the entire melt pool size, which is especially important at higher energy densities when Marangoni forces are strong. 5 new examples are available, demonstrating the various new features in the AM module. Thermo Calc 2024b includes several new products for titanium users. A titanium model library is introduced. This is a package of pre-built property models that allow for easy setup of some of the most common calculations used by those working with titanium-based alloys. 2 property models are included in the new titanium model library: alloy strength for titanium, which calculates the hardness for titanium-based alloys, and martensite temperatures for titanium, which calculates the martensite start temperature and T0 temperatures for titanium-based alloys. 2 examples are included in the release demonstrating these 2 models. The new titanium model library is available for free to all users who upgrade to the new titanium alloys database TCTI6, which we will discuss later in this video, and who have a valid maintenance and support subscription. Elastic properties are introduced in Thermo Calc 2024b. As of this release, 3 elastic moduli are available for plotting and analysis: bulk modulus, shear modulus, and Young's modulus. You can also calculate and plot the independent elastic constants of cubic and hexagonal phases, as shown on the screen. The moduli and constants can be plotted per phase or for all phases. In this release, the elastic properties are only available in the new version of the titanium and TIAL-based alloys database, TCTI6, which we will talk more about later in this video. Elastic properties will be added to additional databases in upcoming releases. One new example is included demonstrating this new feature, as listed on the screen. This new example requires the new TCTI6 database to run. The property model calculator receives a significant speed improvement in the 2024b release with the introduction of parallel calculations. The program now divides calculations into smaller jobs and runs them all at the same time. This feature is turned on by default, but users can turn it off for each calculation or reduce the number of parallel calculations to suit their machine. Users can also change the global default setting from Tools, Options, on the General tab. The setting is called Parallel Calculation for Property Model Calculator. The Martensitic Steel Strength Model in the Steel Model Library has several improvements in the 2024b release, the primary being the addition of a new tempering time field, which predicts the time-dependent effect on tempering. This new feature is primarily based on the physical models listed on the screen, but it was improved upon using a machine learning model that was trained on a large dataset covering mainly carbon and low alloy steels. You can read more about this in our documentation. Example PM-FE10 has been updated for this release to use this new improvement. Thermo Calc 2024b includes 9 new databases, including the introduction of our first ever databases for the refractory alloys molybdenum and niobium. 2 entirely new databases are introduced for molybdenum-based alloys: TCMO1, a thermodynamic and properties database, and MOBMO1, a companion mobilities database. The new molybdenum-based alloys databases are designed for refractory superalloys that function at higher temperatures than nickel-based superalloys. Common applications for molybdenum alloys include aerospace components, electrical contacts, industrial machinery, and high-temperature furnace parts due to their excellent mechanical, thermal, and corrosion-resistant properties. They're also used in the production of high-strength steel alloys, which are crucial in the construction and automotive industries for their durability and resistance to corrosion and heat. The databases have been developed with these applications in mind. TCMO1 includes 12 elements, 167 phases, 66 binary systems, 46 ternary systems, and 3 quaternary systems. The database also includes several additional thermophysical properties, as listed on the screen. A companion mobilities database, MOBMO1, is also released to correspond to TCMO1. This release also introduces 2 completely new databases for niobium-based alloys: TCNB1, a thermodynamic and properties database, and MOBNB1, a companion mobilities database. These databases are designed for niobium-based refractory alloys that exhibit high melting temperatures and low density compared to nickel superalloys. Niobium alloys are commonly used in aerospace and aviation industries for manufacturing superalloys that are heat resistant and can withstand high stress environments, such as jet engines and gas turbines. Niobium alloys are also used in medical implants due to their biocompatibility and corrosion resistance. Additionally, they are used in the production of superconductors for applications like MRI machines and particle accelerators. In the automotive sector, niobium alloys are used for lightweighting and improving the strength of structural components. TCMB1 includes 12 elements, 101 phases, 66 binary systems, and 76 ternary systems. The database also includes several additional thermophysical properties, as listed on the screen. A companion mobilities database, MobNB1, is also released to correspond to TCNB1. A new version of our titanium-based alloys database, TCTI6, is available with the 2024B release. This database is the first to add elastic properties. It includes 3 elastic moduli and the independent elastic constants of cubic and hexagonal phases, as shown on the screen. The database also updates several systems and phases related to shape memory alloys, improved surface tension in the iron-nickel system, and more. Users who purchase or upgrade to this new database also receive the new titanium model library for free. The companion mobilities database, MobTI5, is updated to correspond to TCTI6. This release also includes an update to the aluminum-based alloys database, TCAL9. To learn more about all of the new improvements, features, upgrades, and databases in Thermo Calc 2024b, visit the release news page on our website at thermocalc.com/releasenews.